Good evening, everybody. For you. Growing up, I got a chance to participate as a volunteer in Special Olympics in Texas where my brother, Brett, who has cerebral palsy, competed. So events like this mean a lot to me. It's the reason why nearly three decades later, it's an honor for me to be up here tonight celebrating the athletes, the partners, and the families. I think back to last Monday with National Soccer Club at our brand new stadium, Geodis Park, where we welcomed in the inaugural Special Olympics Unified Team in partnership with Special Olympics Tennessee, and the memories that we made that day going out onto the field, kicking a soccer ball, and just thinking about the journey we're going to embark on together with Ballard College Prep and Franklin High being the representatives this year with National Soccer Club. Memories were made that day, memories will be made as we have our inaugural gold versus blue game in the coming weeks. And much like this weekend, some memories will be made. This is a special time, a special moment, a special ceremony to be a part of today. And I'm very excited to be here tonight. And for this weekend of competition, but I'm sure all of you are more excited to get this ceremony started. Yeah. Am I right? Yeah. So, let's give a big, a loud, a raucous welcome to the 2022 Summer Game Athletes, Unified Sports Partners, and Coaches.
athletes to compete this weekend. You guys are going to do great. And it's been such a wonderful year between Special Olympics and the Tennessee Titans and partnering with Music City Blitz and the Polar Fund. Go have fun, go do your best, and the Tennessee Titans are behind you all the way.
Hello everyone and welcome. I love seeing everyone's faces in person for the first time in 2 years. I'm Hayley Wielgus. I am the chair of the Board of Directors for Special Olympics Tennessee, and I'll be up here to talk on behalf of all of our board members. Once again, we are so proud to be here in person and to have this wonderful weekend together. You may not know all of our faces, you may not know all of our names on the board, but we are some of your biggest cheerleaders. We talk about you all the time, to our friends, our family, our coworkers. We talk about your courageousness, your athleticism, your competitiveness, your grit, and your dedication to this sport. And that dedication is shown tonight because through 2 years of a pandemic, you stuck with this, you came back to compete, and you're ready to show up tomorrow. So we are wishing you a big good luck. We want you to win some medals. We want you to compete hard. But most importantly, we want you to have fun and enjoy being together. So good luck on behalf of all of us on the board. And thank you to all of our volunteers, to our sponsors, to our staff, because they make all of this happen. And I'll see you tomorrow.
Let's give one more big hand for Hayley. Well said, Hayley. You know, as Hayley mentioned, there are over 1,000 sponsors that are volunteers this weekend that will volunteer as timers, scorekeepers, officials, medical personnel, logistics personnel, marketing personnel, housing and dining personnel, just downright fans of you all. These are people that are dedicating their time to be here for you because we want to see you all shine as one. The theme of this year's 2022 Summer Games has been Shine as One, and watching each of you athletes walk across the stage here today and get your plaudits and your cheers and your ovation has been nothing short of heartwarming and fulfilling, and seeing you all go out and give your best tomorrow is the best way to say thank you to all of the volunteers who are here to support you. There are over 800 athletes and coaches this year at the 2022 State Summer Games, and we're going to be able to hear from a lot of very special people here tonight, and there's a lot of special people that helped make tonight happen. Now, there's way too many to name, but there are a few that I do want to single out first and foremost. The Director of Special Events, Beth Teagarden. Beth and her team with Shelby Christensen, they've done an amazing job setting up tonight. We've got Adam Germick, who here from a little bit, the CEO of Special Olympics Tennessee as well. And countless others who have dedicated weeks and months to making today possible. So without them, tonight wouldn't happen. And it is a very, very special honor to be able to welcome up the next gentleman to the stage. He is the VP of University Relations here at Lipscomb University. He is a longtime friend and supporter of Special Olympics, Mr. Walt Lieber.
State Olympic Games. Congratulations. Now will you pray with me? Our Father in Heaven, thank you so much for this wonderful day. Thank you for this wonderful group of athletes who worked so hard to be here, for their coaches, for their family members, for their friends, for all of the people who've worked so hard to make this Olympic Games so special. And Father, we pray for these next couple of days that everybody will play hard, play with great sportsmanship. They will enjoy every experience, and they'll realize that you're the one that makes it all possible. Father, we thank you for your love. We thank you for watching over us. We're thankful for the safe trip that everybody had to get here. And Father, we pray for a safe travel going home. And Father, we give you the glory and the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Next up is our call for presentation of colors. So would you all please stand as the color guard of Metro Nashville Police Department present the colors. Please remain standing as Eric Wilson, a Williamson County athlete, leads us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
and know that they're supporting you and cheering you all the way.
Volunteer and fundraise to support Special Olympics. All 50 states and more than 35 countries currently have law enforcement torch run programs and support Special Olympics. We are excited to be here today and support Special Olympics Tennessee at the 2022 State Summer Games at Lipscomb University. And now, in a tradition that dates to the first Special Olympics, join me in welcoming the arrival of the Special Olympics Flame of Hope.
Light the cauldron.
And now it is my privilege and honor to welcome the CEO and President of Special Olympics Tennessee, Adam Gurman.
Great to see all of y'all. Who's ready for the games this weekend? Well, it's been 2 years, two long years, right? And we are so excited to be back on this beautiful campus. So thankful for Lipscomb University, Lipscomb Academy, Lipscomb Dining, and all of our friends here at Lipscomb. Let's give a huge round of applause for our wonderful hosts. In order to make today, tomorrow happen, we have some wonderful partners that I just want to recognize very quickly, but give them time to get their moments with all of you to let you know who is supporting you out in your communities. So our statewide sponsors for Special Olympics, big round of applause, you can save it to the end, is Aviator Supply Chain Solutions, the Galisano Foundation, the CDC, the Department of Special Education, Jackson, Publix, Jersey Mike Subs, the Tennessee Titans, always a fan favorite, LifePoint Health, the Bob Mannery Foundation, and the Brighter Days Foundation. Let's give a big round of applause to our statewide partners. We'd also like to recognize all of our premier partners, including Tennessee Soccer Club, United Way of Greater Nashville, the Knights of Columbus, Delta Dental, St. Matthew School, the Nashville Predators, obviously all of our amazing law enforcement members for Law Enforcement Torturon, they're amazing. And one of our newest partners, we've had the luxury and the privilege to hang out with Jamie today and other days, Nashville SC, our newest soccer team in Nashville. We'll all be cheering them on Saturday night. We can't wait for another W in Geodis Park. And our summer game sponsors, our Young Professionals Board, Chick-fil-A, amazing hosts, Lipscomb University, thank you all. Lipscomb Academy, we have a special guest later on from Lipscomb Academy. And Lipscomb Dining, the wonderful food you'll eat all weekend. And I'm also really, really excited to introduce someone to you all that's so happy to be here today and to announce a new partnership with the state of Tennessee and the Department of Intellectual and Developmental Disabilities, Commissioner Brad Turner.
Thank you, Adam. It is certainly an honor to be here. I'm incredibly excited. Just seeing all of your faces, athletes, knowing what you had to do to compete, to prepare, to practice, to do your very best, it is my honor to be here. We are certainly excited to be partnering with Special Olympics. As Adam said, my name is Commissioner Brad Turner, but I want you to know first and foremost, I am the parent of a Special Olympian named Kinsley Turner in Rutherford County. She is the light of my life. She is my inspiration. She is the reason I get up every day and have the privilege to hold the job that I do. And I want to say to her, even though she's not here, how much I love her and how much she inspires me in the very same manner that these athletes, I'm sure, inspire all of us all across the state of Tennessee. There's a lot of guardians, there's a lot of people that love these athletes. I want to tell you thank you from the bottom of my heart as a parent for the sacrifices that you've made, for the path that you've been asked to walk that might look a little bit different than what our neighbors and our friends and their families have to walk. But believe me, it is so much more rewarding when we see ourselves in a space like this and our children and our loved ones being recognized for their accomplishments, not only athletically, but the stories that are being told to us through the community and how they gather together to bring out the very best in their neighbor. And I think that's something that this state and this country desperately need more of, is seeing the best in each other and not the worst. And making sure that we acknowledge that, we value that, we invest in each other, we continue to cheer each other to new heights and even greater successes. This portion of the program, I certainly don't want to take up any more time that's been allotted to me, but I want to make sure that I address the athletes directly and look as many of them in the eye as I can. I got a chance to give high fives to a lot of the athletes that came in on the left side of the arena, and Coach Dilfer had the privilege to be able to do it on the right side of the arena. I want each one of you to know and to hear from me that you are fearfully and wonderfully made in the image of God. Every able to take that flame and carry it around and be able to light it outside the arena. And I want you to remember today, tomorrow, Sunday, and moving forward that God has put a flame inside your own heart. That burns very, very, very bright. And I want you to remember that whether you come in first place tomorrow or whether you see your friend come in first place, and whatever you do tomorrow, do everything that you can do to the glory of God, and you will be honored by Him because of what you're doing. The last thing I'm going to say is this. Before you start in any event tomorrow, I want you to repeat three very important words that I try to share with everyone that's in my department across the state that I come in contact with. I am worthy. You're worthy to be who you are. You're worthy to be part of our community. And most importantly, for tonight, for tomorrow, and Sunday, you're worthy to be an Olympian. So say those three words. I am worthy. And repeat that every single time you want to do that tomorrow. God bless you, Special Olympics. Thanks for letting me be here. Go be great.
Taking pains, yeah, he's on. for the shirt.
And welcome to the summer game.
We're so excited for the game and to see you compete this weekend. It's been such a wonderful year between Special Olympics of Tennessee and Assyrian with our participation in Polar Plunge. I plunged.
I watched.
Yes, you did. Have fun tomorrow when you compete. Do your best and know that we're supporting and cheering for you all the way.
Come on, let's go.
Good evening, everyone, and hello to everyone. My name is Bradley Brown, and I'm a Special Olympic athlete, a coach, a leader, and now a staff member, and it is my honor to introduce our guest speaker, Mr. Trent Dilfer. I already told him a minute ago that I probably said his name wrong, so please don't kill me. And then, he's played in the NFL for 14 seasons. He started quarterback for the Baltimore Ravens when they won it in 2000. After retiring, he became an analyst for the ESPN, and now he's the head football coach at Lipscomb Academy. Please give a warm welcome to Coach Trent Dilfer.
I want to thank you guys, specifically the athletes, but I want to thank you in a little bit different way. I want to probably tell you something about yourself that you don't even know. And I'm really lucky in the sense that my 14 years in the NFL, 9 years on television, ESPN, and now what I have the honor and privilege of doing today, which is coaching young people, I've been able to study greatness, been around greatness, experience greatness. I myself was not great. If anybody tells you that, they're lying. But I got to play with some great players. I played on the same teams as myself, 12 Hall of Famers. Those are the best in the world in football. I got to play with 12 of them. I got to compete against dozens of them in the field of battle. I noticed this about great players. I noticed this about really the greatest of the world in anything that they do. And they do something very similar to you. Is that they fall in love with something. They fall in love with what I call the chase. You guys know what I mean by the chase? They're chasing their best every single day. They're chasing something that God put in them that they recognize is unlimited and untapped. And they wake up every single day and they say, I'm gonna chase something that nobody else even knows is out there. Notice how I didn't say they're chasing a win. See, the greatest I learned don't have a finish line. There is no Super Bowl. There is no NBA championship. There is no gold medal. That's not what they're chasing. They're chasing something bigger than that. They're chasing their best, and on the path of their chase, they might happen to accomplish those things, but that's not really what wakes them up in the morning. The greatest of the great chase their personal best with no finish line, and I want to thank you athletes, because I think you do the same thing. I think the group in this room does something bigger than trying to win a medal or win a race or win a competition. You're chasing your personal best. And like Brad said, your best is so much bigger than you even realize, because you're created by the creator of the universe with something in you so powerful and so magnificent and so awesome that if you just continue to chase that, you'll see amazing things happen. But I want to thank you for this reason, because as you chase the chase, you make me better. You make the people around you better. You make our world better. Boy, we know our world needs to be better, right? Because by your chase, you're inspiring others for them to be better. Your courage and your bravery in the midst of hard things and challenging things is an example for so many people that they need to realize there is no finish line. There is no win. There is no loss. There's simply a chase. And if we all just woke up in the morning like you all do and say, God made me an incredible win, I'm going to go chase that forever while I'm on this earth, imagine how much better it will all be. So thank you. Thank you so much for inspiring me. Thank you for inspiring the people around you. Thank you for being willing to take on the great challenge of the chase. Here's the last thing I've learned about greatness. It's not easy, is it? Brutally hard, isn't it? The best embrace hard things. They look for hard things, actually. I'm thinking of like Ray Lewis and Kobe Bryant and these the best of the best that have ever lived. They wake up and they look for the next hard thing. They look for the next challenge. Because they know if they can continue to chase their best and overcome hard things, that they're going to make the people around them better and they'll be better themselves. They also don't mind being a little uncomfortable. In fact, what I've learned is that the greatest of the great love hard things and they become comfortable in uncomfortable situations. It becomes their norm. It becomes almost like, I have to go find hard things and I have to be uncomfortable, because if I'm not, I'm not really living and I'm not really pursuing all that I can be. I bet you that resonates with a lot of you, because it hasn't been easy. It has been uncomfortable. But yet you've pushed through, and your bravery and your courage has allowed you to do so many things that most people tap out and will never do. So again, thank you for that. I want to be very sensitive to everybody's time, and I've already been so blessed by being here tonight. I want to thank you for wanting to be a part of this. Like, when I say I love awesome things and epic things, this is an awesome, epic thing. This weekend's an awesome, epic thing, and I'm humbled and thankful that I get to be a part of this. I'll leave you with this, and it's a little redundant, but I'll just repeat what I said earlier, that every morning when you wake up, thank the God that created you for the opportunity to do hard things. So maybe be a little uncomfortable, right? The chance to chase something he put inside you that only he could have done. And remember this, you're not doing it just for yourself, right? You fire me up right now, because I think you guys get it more than most athletes. You're doing it for something way bigger than you. Because as you chase the chase, as you chase your best, you are actively making all of us better. And as you make all of us better, slowly but surely, we as a state get better. And then slowly but surely, our state makes the other states better. And imagine if we all just woke up every single morning and said, I'm going to chase the God of the universe, what he put in me, and my best. If we all just did that, I think the world would be a better place to live. And you guys are thinking about it.
Well, we've been very fortunate to hear some incredible speakers tonight. It's very poignant
what Trent just said, those three words, chase the chase. And what was said just before that, I am worthy. A couple of key things tonight that I think we're all better off for hearing, so thank you, gentlemen, for those speeches. Those are amazing. I'm getting fired up after those speeches, and it's been an incredible night. Where we get to present an individual award. Now, everyone in here is special in their own right. And tonight we get to present the very special Alan Bullock Athlete of the Year Award. And it's given to a Special Olympic athlete who represents the Special Olympics mission and hope. This year we have several nominees who have been a great example of an athlete dedicated to sports training, leadership skills, and being a strong Special Olympics advocate in their community. So when I say your names, I'd like to invite you up here in front of the stage, and we'll welcome you in one-on-one and one-by-one, and then we'll announce our winner. So let's get loud, let's get excited, let's give them a big, warm welcome. Would the athletes all stand and please repeat after us?
Let me win. I cannot win. And you break and you win.
Let's give one more big round of applause to all of these amazing athletes. give a big round of applause for Don.
I will encourage athletes to demonstrate the same qualities expected of me. Please be seated.
Now, during the parade of athletes, I'm sure everyone noticed the great banners displayed by each area as they entered the arena. Now, to announce the winners of the banner contest, please welcome board member of Special Olympics Tennessee, Jenny Smith. Well, this has been an awesome night full of fun and excitement. Tomorrow, great day full of competition and ending with the victory celebration. Before we do all that, there is still something else we need to do. In 2 weeks' time, the Special Olympics 2022 USA Games will be held in Orlando, Florida. We have a large delegation of over 140 athletes, unified partners, coaches, and staff going to represent Team Tennessee. I would like those people to now stand wherever you are in the arena. Let's give them one last round of applause. Now what's better than one NFL player? Two NFL players. Let's please give a big welcome to former Atlanta Falcon, Tennessee Titan, Las Vegas Raider.
I now declare these 2022 State Summer Games officially open. Let's go.